Hello viewers, welcome to my channel. I'm Hashim Ali Khan. Now in this video I'm going to explain you about social responsibility accounting. This is the topic under the subject advanced corporate accounting. So I'm going to explain you the theoretical part of social responsibility accounting. No problems will be there, only theoretical explanation I'm going to give you. So this video covers the topic, the meaning of the term social responsibility. What is the nature of social responsibility? Then social responsibility of business, and what are the objectives of social responsibility of business? Then I am going to explain you social responsibility accounting. What do you mean by accounting? Then objectives of social responsibility accounting, and lastly, indicators of social performance of organizations. So these are the things I'm going to explain you in this video. Watch the video till the end, because in examination you will get a theory question regarding this topic of social responsibility. First of all, business is a part of the society, particularly a corporate. Nowadays the important business organization is companies, corporate organization, which is an artificial person created by law. So as natural person, we have some responsibilities towards the society. Similarly, a business organization, particularly a corporate form of business organization, will have more responsibilities towards the society. The main objective still is to earn the profit. But a business cannot survive for long if we keep the objective of maximizing the profit as the sole objective. The business cannot survive for long period of time. Then it has to consider the interest of different stakeholders. Apart from the shareholders, there are other parties who are having stake in the business, like customers are there, employees are there, government is there, and the society at large. So the business organization have to satisfy the stake, the interest of different parties. So a business will become successful only when it satisfies the interest of all the parties. That is the broad goal of the business, to satisfy the stake of all the parties. That means the objective is not only to earn the profit or to maximize the shareholders' wealth. Apart from that, a number of other obligations are there, responsibilities are there, that we are going to study now. Now, what is the nature of social responsibility? What is the nature of social responsibility? So there are three different approaches given for studying the nature of social responsibility. The oldest approach, the classical economists have given the approach of social responsibility as maximization of returns, maximization of incomes. So according to the oldest approach, when a business organization earns a profit and utilize all the resources effectively without wastage and not detrimental to any party, that means automatically social responsibility is over, because it is not misusing any resource. It is using the resources to satisfy the owner's wealth. That is the oldest approach of social responsibility. But as the years pass on, that means the responsibility of business organizations have increased. Now second approach says balancing of claims of various groups. So we have moved on from owners to other parties, because a business organization, owners are not the only party who has invested, who are having a stake in the business. A corporation, a company will have so many parties who are having stake in the business. So it is the responsibility of the corporate manager to perform the functions in such a way that it should satisfy the interest of all the parties. Like bankers have given the loan, the company has the responsibility of paying the interest and repaying the loan. Similarly, the creditors have supplied the goods to the company. It is the responsibility of the business to pay timely to the creditors. Similarly, it is the responsibility of the corporate managers to pay timely taxes to the government. So these are all the responsibility. So the second approach says the social responsibility consists of satisfying the claims of all the parties who are having stake in the business. Now, third approach, that is the more wide approach of social responsibility, says reconciling the expectation of different parties towards the company. Who are the parties? Reconciling the demand of employees. The employees are the biggest main resource which every organization will use. So expectation of the employees are, they want a good remuneration, they want good other benefits, non-monetary or monetary benefits, they want some growth in their prospects. All these things are there. So management must recognize that these are the expectation of the employees and we have to satisfy that. Secondly, customer for lower prices and greater values. The customers are the main parties who are having direct relationship with the company, because the company is using the resources of the society and providing the goods and services to the society. Well, what the society, what the consumers demand? The consumers demands the goods, better quality goods at a lower price. At a lower price. Thirdly, the shareholders for higher dividend and capital appreciation. The owners, the investors expects from the company, from the business, a higher rate of dividend, a good capital appreciation. So not only this, apart from that, so many objectives are there. So the planners, the corporate managers have to reconcile all the demands, all the expectations of all the parties. Then only the company will survive for a long period of time. No doubt, ignoring the profit objective, a business organization cannot give the social responsibilities. Social responsibilities comes next. First of all, a company must earn sufficient to provide for the survival. After earning sufficient profit, then only the organization can spend money on the social responsibility. So these are the approaches, nature of social responsibility. Now, social responsibility of business. See here, a business organization consumes the resources of the society and provides the goods and services which are needed by the society. That means there's a direct relationship between the society and the business organization. The business organization using the resources and providing the goods and services to the society. So if the business thinks of only income point of view, ignoring the society, then the business will not run long. If the business wants to survive for a long period of time, it should consider the society. It is having the responsibility towards the society. So what are the responsibility? Now we are going to study one by one. That is objectives of social responsibility. What are the objectives of social responsibility? What a business organization can do towards the society. First one, efficient utilization of resources. See, we are given the natural resources. So many natural resources are there. These natural resources are being used by the organization, by a firm. Now it is the responsibility of the firm that these resources should be effectively utilized, efficiently utilized. No resources should go waste. Wastage should be kept at its minimum. So that is the first responsibility. No natural resources should go waste. Every resource should be effectively utilized. Secondly, maximizing customer satisfaction. See, there is no business without customer. The business will be there only on account of customer. If there are no customers at all, no business. So what the customers requires? The customers require better quality goods at a reasonable price. So it is the responsibility of the organization to provide better quality goods to the satisfaction of the customers, and at a reasonable price, not exorbitant price, at reasonable price. So this is also one of the social responsibility. Third one, employee contentment. Employee contentment. That means the employees are the main resource of the organization. In any organization, the main, the very important resource is the human resource. But unfortunately, the payment made to human resource or employees will be kept at minimum so that the cost reduction can be done. This will be the, mentality of the employers, but it is not correct. The employees should be satisfied. That means not only better remuneration, but also apart from that, the employer has to spend the money on the development or skills, job skills of the workers should be increased by providing the training, by providing different facilities. Apart from that, a number of benefits should be given to the employees. So when the employees are content, then definitely the productivity will increase. There should not be any unrest among the employees. Next one, support government initiatives. It is the responsibility of the government to bring a number of social benefits. The government has implemented a number of schemes. So the business organization should support, should complement the schemes of the government. First of all, the business organization should pay promptly taxes to the government. Similarly, at the same time, the government have different plans for economic development of different regions, to control the pollution, to remove the unemployment. These are all the objectives, activities of the government. So this business organization will support, should support the government in completing those activities, those objectives. Last one, service to the society. Because the business organization is consuming the resources of the society, providing the goods and services to the society, so it is the responsibility of the business organization to help the society, to help the society in different forms. How the business organization can start some schools, some colleges, some hospitals, like that, some religious places, or all these things for laying the roads, for removing the pollution, for removing the unemployment. So all these things, the business organization can be able to help the society. So these are some of the objectives of social responsibilities. Now I'm going to explain you about social responsibility accounting. So far we have discussed about only the responsibilities. Now I'm going to discuss you about social responsibility accounting. What do you mean by social responsibility accounting? The contribution made by an organization, that means the cost and benefit to the society, the cost and benefit to the society by the business organization in conducting its operations, in conducting its business activities. So while doing the business activities, what are the cost and what are the benefits it is providing to the society? That should be recorded, identified, recorded, then analyzed and reported. That is social responsibility accounting. Accounting does not mean only recording the financial transactions. Only financial transaction is not the only accounting. This is also one of the branch of accounting. Social responsibility accounting is also one of the branch of accounting, which is concerned with providing the information regarding what are the cost and benefit incurred and given by the company to the society. How much cost it has taken to the from the society and how much benefit it is providing to the society while conducting its activities. That is called social responsibility accounting. Now the social responsibility accounting have been used by different terms. It is also called social cost benefit analysis or social information system or social accounting or social responsibility accounting or report on corporate social policies or social audit or socio-economic accounting, etc. are often interchangeably used to convey the same meaning. These are the different terms which are used to convey the same meaning regarding social responsibility accounting. That means what are the costs, what are the benefits given and taken by the organization to the society. That should be recorded. That is called social responsibility accounting. Now, objectives of social accounting. Why this social accounting is needed? What are the objectives? First of all, identification and measurement of net social contribution. How much net social contribution? That means benefit minus cost. Net social contribution means benefit minus cost. How much benefit the organization is giving to the society and how much cost it is incurring towards the society. So, first of all, objective of this social responsibility accounting is to identify. We have to see, the business organization has to see, identify how much we are incurring on social benefit. Secondly, balance between firm strategy and social priorities. See here, two different strategies should be made. One, business strategies. Second, social strategies. That means there should be some harmony in these two strategies. We should not neglect one strategy over the other. If the business organization focus only on company strategies, only on the profit making strategies, ignoring the social responsibility, the company cannot run for long period. Similarly, if the company focuses only on social responsibility, ignoring the company profit making strategies, then definitely company will collapse. Without income, the company cannot survive. There should be a balance between these two strategies, that is income strategy and social strategies. Next comes communication of information. Social responsibility should be communicated, should be told to the people, to the public, to the society. That means a business organization has to communicate to the society that we are doing so and so activities for social responsibility, as a responsibility towards the society. So how much it is spending on human welfare, how much amount he is paying the taxes, how much amount spent in laying the roads, how much amount spent on controlling the pollution. All these things should be reported. That is communication. These are the objectives of social responsibility accounting. Now, last topic I am going to explain you about indicators of social performance. How we can be able to know that a company is performing social responsibility, doing responsibility towards the society. What are the indicators? The first indicator, net income contribution. First of all, only a financially strong company can give the help to the society, can perform the social goals, only if it is having sufficient income. A bad financial, a company which is financially not good cannot help others. First of all, if you want to help others, you should be strong. So similarly, a company which wants to perform social goals, social obligations, it has to earn sufficient income. So first of all, if the income of a company, if the income of a corporation is high, then only it can be able to perform the social activities. Secondly, human resource contribution. A company will spend lot of money on the employees and workers in the form of remuneration, wages, welfare scheme, benefits, whether it is cash benefit or non-cash benefit, all these things. So if a company is spending good amount on human resources, that means the workers and employees are fully satisfied, the productivity, the labor productivity is good, the labor turnover is very low, in that case it indicates that there is social responsibility. There's a good social responsibility of the business. Thirdly, contribution to public. Contribution to public means the company has paid regularly, promptly a good amount of taxes. A good amount of taxes has been paid by the company. Apart from that, the company has spent the money on different social activities. Social activities like laying the roads or reducing the pollution or starting up some schools or health facilities, some hospitals. All these are the public services given by the company. Second, environmental contribution. Due to this industrial activities, the pollution, the environment will get affected. There will be pollution. So a company has to spend the money to reduce the pollution, to minimize the pollution. So how much amount the company is spending in order to reduce the pollution. The last one, product or service contribution. The product or service which is giving, the organization, the business organization is producing the goods or providing the service, it should be quality goods. It should satisfy the needs of the customers. The needs of the customers. It should not be detrimental to the interest of the customers. So these are the indicators which shows the social responsibility accounting of the business organization. So I have explained you about the meaning of social responsibility in nature, then social responsibility of business, objectives of social responsibility of business, then social responsibility accounting, and what are the objectives of this accounting, and what are the indicators of social performance. So after watching this video, you will be in a position to write in examination the theory part of social responsibility. Some more topics are there in this social responsibility. We'll continue in the next video.